Hey guys, we're playing Ultima V again. So we're right back where we left off last episode, after having restored our save right before we entered the dungeon Destard. The main thing I'd like to do today is to explore that dungeon and kill a bunch of stuff, get some good loot in it. But there's a little bit of business I'd like to take care of first. The first thing I'd like to do is not fight those giant rats, but go buy Barnabas a halberd, because his weapons just aren't quite cutting it. And a halberd is a great thing to have. I guess that's my ship. I don't remember parking it there. So I'll go into Trinzic in a moment, but there's also something I want to do in Britain. So while the sun rises, let's head in that direction. Oh, by the way, these are the Fens of the Dead. I searched around here a little bit and couldn't find any spot that had Mandrake in it, so I'm going to have to figure out which square exactly that is. But it can only be found at midnight, so I don't have a lot of opportunities to search everywhere each night. But yeah, we're going to go to Britain, and I did some experimentation. Oh man, that's right, there's a Shadow Lord here. I know there was a Shadow Lord there because I was doing some experimentation in the same save file, so I guess we'll go to Trinzic first. Did some experimentation with Annan, and it turns out that when he says, "I do not yet trust thy virtue," he is actually taking a look at my karma level, or virtue. I think virtue is what they actually call it in-game, so I'll change my terminology. So we have 79 virtue right now. He actually takes a look at that, and uses it to make a determination of whether he'll give you the word of power or not. And I have enough now. So it turns out you have to have at least, let's see, what do my notes say? I think it's 75? Yeah, if you have at least 75, he will talk. So, on the next day, if there's no Shadow Lord there, we'll go get the word of power from him. Let's see, right, I wanted to buy this guy halberd. That is what I would like to do. Buy C. Yes, I can just afford it. Excellent. And, I just did this, but I restored the save so I could bring you guys along for the ride. Scale mail's kind of heavy, but I think if I just take that off, I should be able to wield this. Yeah, because now with that wielded, I can't do that anymore. Can I go up to an iron helm? Yes, okay. So that's good. I'd like to give him a spiked helm, but I don't currently own one of those. I could buy them in Jellum. I got one from a Reaper last time, but had to overwrite that save. Now, I would also kind of like... Oh, hey. Wait a minute. Is this kid... Is that Jimmy? Does he get up? Oh! I didn't know we could actually talk to Jimmy. I thought he just slept all the time. I just like to sit by the lake and think. Oh, try again. It's very relaxing. Really? Really? Okay, I'll visit you again right now. I just like to sit by the lake and think. It's very relaxing. You still have nothing else to say. Wow, you're not too useful. Hang on. What's your father's name? He is in here, right? Oh, wait, let me ask, okay, your name is Wolf. Occasionally let him visit the lake. If that'll see him, ask him about ships. Okay, let's go ask him about ships. Cool. Where'd he go? This is a lake, isn't it? There he is. I love ships. Ever heard of the HMS Cape? No. Many extraordinary powers had she. Twice the hull strength and twice the speed of any other vessel. Ooh! She bore a magical ship's wheel that did enchant her, but oh, goodness. It was lost during the Age of the Avatar. Okay. So, HMS Cape is a very good ship, apparently. But it's lost. Alright, Sindar's in there. We can't talk to him right now. I guess we'll head for Britain and take care of our business there. Another thing we really need to do is go see Elistaria. Maybe I'll actually do that right now, because that's the other thing we really wanted to do with our with our grappling hook. So let me figure out how to get there from here, and I'll see you once I'm on that island. Oh man, this whirlpool really wants to get me, but I'm just going to stay away from it. All right, sun's just about to come up. I think this thing I'm coming up on might be her island right here. Is this, no. Where the hell am I? Oh, okay, I'm at the desert. So that means it's over here. Okay. Wait, what? There it is, there it is. Okay. No! No, this is the Isle of the Avatar. This island... This island is not where the map says it is. Here we go. This is what I'm looking for. What does that say? Oh yeah, we've already read this, haven't we? Private island. Visitors not welcome. Beat it. Alright. So yeah, as we know, Elistaria is not a nice person. A very not nice person has sent us to see her. So, alright, Windermere. Let's see what she has to say. We're going to try and join the oppression. Oh, hey, there's a giant rat here. Let's just leave that one alone. Beware. What does that say? Let me translate real quick. I'll bet I can do this on camera. I'm getting better at this. R-O... What's that next one? D... Rodents of something, something, something unusual size. Beware, rodents of unusual size. Okay. Other ones say the same thing? Yep. All right, let's break in here. Oh my goodness. Are these friendly? Hello. No response. So they're not friendly, but they're not attacking me. So that's something at least. Ooh boy, this place makes me nervous. And there's lots of doors. Oh hey, there's a secret door through the fireplace there. Just leads outside, okay. So I guess that's how you get out if the gates are closed. Hello, who are you? Thrud. An infamous mercenary. I enjoy killing immensely. Do you now? Surely thou hast heard of the time when I butchered an entire village, no? I had just returned from a war across the sea when on my way home I stopped at an inn. The meal I ate there gave me indigestion for 2 days. Upon recovery, I killed the innkeeper and his entire staff. Well, you're not a very nice person, are you? The ensuing outcry forced me to dispense with the rest of the village. Good grief. Which village? Okay. So, you're a bad person. Let's see if we can find Elistaria. Oh man, these giant rats are all over the place. Where are you? This must be you. Dabble in the dark arts. Tell me about them. I play with forces beyond the comprehension of most mortals. I conjure daemons and such. Yeah, okay, that explains the two out front. Yes, my favorite creatures. Thou hast seen my two best summonings guarding this keep. Guarding against what? Okay, so I was sent to you by Archmage Flayne, and I'm supposed to just say Impera to you. Ah yes, now I remember. Thou art the one infiltrating the resistance. Here, wear this badge when thou doth wish to show thou art with Blackthorn and the Oppression. Interesting. It may be that Thrud has some items that may be useful in your mission. The jeweled weapons, of course. Ask Thrud for them. Okay. Well, now, you're a rude person. Good grief. She seemed not so horrible until I said bye. Then she's just like, be gone, wretch. Okay. The jeweled sword and shield are fine weapons indeed. Wouldst thou like them? Sure, I guess. I will let thee have these great weapons for the Resistance's password, which thou hast so cleverly discovered. Ooh. I'm not sure I want to give you that. What if I lie? Oh, dear. He's called the guards. All right, let's give it to him. Oh. Oh, yeah. I've made a mess here. Let's try this again. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Ooh. Gotta do some dodging here. Keep track of my turns so I know I can get by. All right. So, just out of curiosity. All right. That's 79. All right. Let's make sure that's reset it. I think it resets when you leave a place. So, these shouldn't be angry at me anymore. Yeah. Okay. We're good. All right, so lie to him, and he'll call the demons on me. Let's talk to him again. I'll give him the password. Jeweled sword and shield are fine weapons indeed. Wouldst thou like them? What if I say, all right, I'm curious. All right. Yes. I'll let thee have these great weapons of the Resistance passwords. So clever to this here. Tell me, what is it? All right. Darn again. May they serve thee well. Oh, hey, you know what? Let's check on something. All right, so we got the jeweled sword and shield. I happen to know that those are complete crap. They do basically no damage to anything. Wait, where's the jeweled sword? I see a jeweled shield. Where's the sword? I don't have a jeweled sword. He only gave me the shield. Okay, whatever. I'm never going to use them anyway. What if they'd sell for much? Will he give me another? Oh, he gave me another jeweled shield. How about that? All right, if they sell for any money at all, then I can just... fleece this guy for all he's worth. That might be a good thing to do. Since these are such terrible people. Oh, well, guess we have to fight these guys. Alright, well, this shouldn't take long. So let's see, what did we get there? What did we learn from... what's her name? Elistaria. Oh, we got the black badge. Yeah. Let's take a look at that. And I think we're going to want to go to that one lighthouse that had all the Blackthorn followers in it. I'm guessing this might come into play during the mission to steal the crown. So that could be interesting. But let's just take a look at this thing. So, let's see. Yeah, black badge. Badge worn. Okay, so it gives me a little thingy right here. It tells me I'm wearing it. Let's take it off. So yeah, I think some people will react differently to me when I have that on. Alright, so hopefully giving up the... Oh, you bastard. Hopefully giving up the password won't have any lasting consequences. How can I avoid fighting this thing? Like this. Board, fire. Alright, that did me some damage. I should probably swing by Minok and get some healing. It's just over here. So let's do that. Yeah, so I am going to be curious what exactly happens when I talk to people wearing the badge. Is this Minok? I gotta be close. Where am I? I don't know where I am. This is not familiar. Wait, no, this isn't... what am I thinking? This is you. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's the Shrine of Justice, which we have already completed. Minok is over here. Somewhere? Yeah, that's it. Okay. So let me just sleep the night away. And let's see, we wanted to go to Britain and talk to Annan. All right, yeah, hopefully that won't have any lasting consequences. My karma is still 79, so that's good. Yeah, I'll sleep for a little bit. You look the healthiest. Then we'll get some healing and move on to Britain, then head for Destart. Okay. Is this going to pass without incident? No. All right, well, we're mostly healed. Barnabas can just deal with a little bit of missing life. Okay, that's fine. So I'm going to head for Britain. I'll see you when I get there. Well, on my way there, I happened upon this little hut out in the middle of the ocean. Let's see what this is about. I am curious. Oh, it doesn't have a name. What kind of place is this? Does anybody live here? Oh, there's a person. Sutek. Yes. I've been scrying for the nature of the three shards. Ooh! I have learned they were formed at the time of the first Dark Lord. Would that be Mundane? Yeah. When Mundane's gem of immortality was destroyed, that's from Ultima One. Which I've actually never played, I've just read about it. Its shards still harbored unspeakable evil. They lay festering deep within the earth, but now their malevolent power has been unleashed upon the world. The shards and the Shadow Lords can and must be destroyed. The shards must be recovered from their resting places in the boundless underworld and cast into the eternal flames of truth, love, and courage. Even as each respective Shadow Lord stands nigh upon the flame of the principle it opposes. Take now this knowledge and use it well. Thank you. You're a great person. Okay, so, what? Ooh, Untim! Nice! Kalzin Corp, awesome. So, what he told us, I happen to already know. Basically, you have to, I'm not sure if there was somebody who was going to send me over there, or if I was just supposed to happen upon it by accident, but I happened upon it by accident, so that's how we found that stuff out. Yeah, so you have to go to each keep once you've found the shard, yell the Shadow Lord's name to call it there, kite it onto the flame, then put the shard into the flame, and that kills that Shadow Lord. So that's how that goes. We will be doing that once we get a hold of some of those shards. Now, where am I? Where the hell am I? What is this? Nothing here looks familiar. Oops. What could that possibly be right there? There's some sort of landmark. Oops. It's a path. Oh, that's pause. Okay. So I'm close to where I wanted to be. Good. Alright, anyway, so we're heading to Britain to talk to Annan and get the word of power from him since I have enough virtue now. I'm going to have to sleep through the night again. Maybe I can find a convenient bed in here. Let's go look for one. Maybe in the inn? Could probably find an unoccupied bed in the inn. That's where I want to be anyway. Or is he nocturnal? No. Any empty beds? Oh, you're a guard. Not helpful. There's an empty bed. Alright, so I was thrown out of bed. I don't think Annan gets up for another couple of hours, so let's just sleep for two more hours in this now unoccupied bed and see if we can track him down. There he is. We use these words to seal the eight dungeons. Seal, Blackthorn hunts us down, Blackthorn. I know merely one of these words. Dost thou wish to know it? See, so he's telling me now. The word is Villis, and remember, it can be used to open the dungeon Despise. The daughter of another council member works as a sailmaker. Ask the child about her mother, for she too knows one of the words of power. The daughter of another council member works as a sailmaker. That's not very specific. Hmm. Okay, well, we learned Villis. I can't, I don't have a place I can, I, oh, good grief. I don't have a place I can type. No! You talk to me. Leave me alone. Oh, yeah, yeah, here we go. I can do this. That's the one. So that will open Despise. Do we have a quest to go into Despise? Get this noisy fountain off my screen. Okay, Shard of Falsehood is below Deceit. Shard of Cowardice is below Hythloth, which is on the Isle of the Avatar. I think those are the only two dungeons that we have a specific purpose to go through. So the others are just places to explore and get some cool loot. So, you know what? I am tempted to check out Despise. Let's at least try it and gauge whether it's tougher than Destard. So Despise, as we know, is up here. Tucked away in the mountains through Serpent's Pass. And you know what? Being over here has made me think of something. Let's go get that glass sword that was in the wrecked airship in these mountains. This is the Serpent's Spine or whatever it was called. If I view a gem right here, you can see that there's a patch of grass right there. So just over here. Let's go to that. And search it. And we get a glass sword. So the glass sword is neat. It's basically a one-shot kill that you can use once. Oh, I wanted to see how much the jeweled shield sold for. I will do that next time I'm near a town. But first, we have a dungeon to poke our heads into. This is Despise. Yell Villis. Okay, let's see what Despise is like. My health's a bit low. I just saved. We're just poking our heads in here to see what it's like. I'm hoping that since it's the dungeon that corresponds to Britain, which is sort of the first place... Oh, look, there's writing on the wall. The Maze of Lost Souls? The Maze of Lost Souls. Ooh, that doesn't sound like much fun. Yeah, I'm hoping since this corresponds to Britain, which is sort of the first town you're going to come to, that it won't be too nasty. But we will see if that holds true. Alright, we know what combat with slimes is like, so I will skip past this. Alright, slimes vanquished, that wasn't too bad. Barnabas took a bunch of damage from party members missing and hitting him instead of what they were aiming at, so that was a bit annoying. Okay, well, there's a trapdoor. Alright, so this place has trapdoors, that's good to know. I should probably do something about his state of health. Let's drink a... I have one white potion. I'm fairly certain that's Mani. Let's find out. Oh, no noticeable effect now. Man, what potion is what? I don't even know. Let's try another. So we know it's not yellow, right? Blue, red, green, orange, blah. Ah, screw it. I'm just going to cast. That helped a little bit. How about if a mage casts it? Maybe that'll be more effective. I don't actually know how many of those I have mixed. One of the things I meant to do was to... oh man, are you serious? Was to mix a bunch of reagents together to get some nice spells. Let me try something here. Alright, so the gem showed me a trapdoor there. If I search this way, I can actually find it. Alright, so that's good to know. Let's go back up a level, because I wasn't quite done with level 2. Let's just use gems. Okay, so there's a down there and an up there. Oh, there's a gazer. Alright, let's give it a try. I'm going to try and get out of this dungeon now. Basically, I wanted to at least poke my head in, get out alive. This doesn't look too bad. So I guess, well, we could just continue exploring this one. Can I save my game in the middle of a dungeon? I assume I probably can. I'm not certain it would be a good idea. I'd rather get to the exit each time I want to save. So let's see if we can at least find our way back out alive. I'm going to save out there. If I can do that successfully, then we'll explore this one a little bit more. Thank you. Come on, die before you possess somebody. Yeah, there we go. Halberd's awesome. Great weapon. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. There we go. Alright, so we're on level 2. Where's a way up? And I do not want to fall in another pit. So there's some sort of down right here. Okay, good. That one's revealed, so we know it's there. I wonder if they stay permanently revealed or if they'll be hidden again if I come back in here. I think I took a wrong turn. This is going to lead me down. Yeah. Let's turn back, head upward. See if we can at least get out of this place. Okay. That's fine. Let's see, where am I? I have no idea. Alright, there's a Reaper. Cool, cool. Let's get some Reaper loot. And, you know, hopefully not die to them or anything terrible like that. I'm gonna go ahead and start using magic with my mages because I've been meaning to do that. That's what they're for. They shouldn't just be using crossbows. So let's cast... Oh, crap. Let's cast what they're casting at me, which I believe is Gravpor. Yeah, that's pretty much the same thing. Oops. Meant to cast with you, too. I don't think I have very many of those mixed. I need to mix more. It takes Ash and Pearl, I believe. Which are not the easiest reagents to get, but they're manageable. Alright, Barnabas is not in the best state. Do I have any? Yes, okay, so I still have those. Janna's gonna play healer. Oh! None mixed. Okay, so we don't have any money. Good to know. Alright, let's just kill these guys if we can, quickly. Barnabas can retreat if he needs to, although there's not much of anywhere I can go to get away from these guys. Let's just focus on one. Good, good, we got one chest. Yeah, he needs to move back, so they'll focus on somebody else. Let's just, yeah, Shamino's fine. You move in, you stay where you are, you move back. Why am I not focusing on just one? Alright, we'll focus on the upper one for now. I wonder if, like, if he's hiding be- oops, can't reach that. If he's hiding behind somebody, I wonder if they'll decide to target the one in front instead. Hmm. Yeah, after this battle, I want to get out of this dungeon if I possibly can. Oh, he can hide behind the wall right here and still be able to reach them with the halberd, but they won't be able to get to him. Ooh, that's what I'm going to do. Yeah. None mixed. I knew it. Okay. Well, heck, I could have Shamino do the same thing. That'd probably be a good idea. All right, would you just die already? Ah, I can't reach. Okay. Guess you'll keep attacking that one. It is heavily wounded. That one's critical. Almost there. There we go. Alright, he's still alive. We're fine. We'll get this. Barely. So from what I'm seeing, this seems about the same as Destard. So both good starter dungeons. I wonder if, what's the place called? Deceit is more difficult because it's part of the shard quest. Like, if you're supposed to go to the dungeons that have no other purpose first before you go into the ones that are, like, official quests. I don't know. That's plausible. Alright. Let's have somebody who's high in health search these things just in case we screw up and trigger a trap. Yeah, that's a complex trap. Good stuff. Okay, dagger, scale mail, mace, and shield. Halberd! Oh, we got another halberd! Is that seriously... Wait, in an, that's negate magic. Let's see, what does that actually do? It's my spell chart. In an, negate magic doesn't tell me anything more about it. Okay, so I can use it to dispel something or other, or... Oh, no, 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 that's right. It blocks everybody from using any magic for a number of turns. That's what it is. Oh, man, look at all this. Smell shield, leather armor, ring of invisibility, cool. Amulet of turning, cool. Oh, spiked helm, we wanted one of those. Okay, inquest wis. I'm going to try inquest wis and see if it is, in fact, just like a gem. Dagger, flaming oil, smell shield, chain coif, mace. Another spiked helm, good. Chain coif, oh. Okay, chest in the chest. Oops, oops. Oh man, this chest had all sorts of stuff in it. Quarrels, quarrels, sling. Not as good of stuff, though. In Sanctuary. Railhur. Cool. Alright, let's see if we can get out of here with our lives intact. We sure can. Awesome. Alright, so that was our first successful dungeon run. Wasn't much, but it was something. I'm going to take it and run. Let's see. Is there any reason to seal this up? I guess I don't know if it really affects anything, but let's do it. There's probably no reason to, but yeah, if you yell it again, it'll just seal it back up. I'm gonna save. I think I might have just done that, but yeah. I should head to Minok and get some healing. That's probably a good idea. Let's see. I kind of feel like doing something else this episode. Okay, while I'm heading to Minok, I'll check my notes and figure out what else we need to be doing. Maybe I'll poke my head into Destard again and just get a bit more of a glimpse of what's in there, but I'll decide in a bit, so I'll be right back. Well, here's something. I'm having to sleep off a day because there's a Shadow Lord at Minok right now. This is just sort of southeast of it. Yeah, Minok's like right there. But this spot is one of the places where you can get Mandrake. Let's see here. What time is it currently? It is 6:50 p.m., so let's exit carpet, sleep for 5 hours, and we should be able to get some Mandrake here. Almost. Another thing we need to do is... Oh, okay. Well, I have to wait for an hour. I'm gonna sleep for an hour. Another thing we have to do is visit the Shrine of Spirituality. There we go! 3 sprigs of Mandrake Crit. Yeah, this is the, Fields of Blood or whatever it's called. And yeah, this is the one spot I know where to get Mandrake. Apparently you can find it in the Fens of the Dead somewhere, but haven't figured out where yet. I'll show you the Nightshade spot in a minute. Yeah, one thing we need to do is revisit the Shrine of Spirituality, since I had something to do at midnight right there. Covetous, that's the dungeon. We don't have a word for that one. Maybe we should see if we can discover the Word of Power in here, too. I need to collect all of those. Alright, so let's just rest for another... Oh, heck, let's not even. I think... Yeah, it's... Oops. Every episode, I tell you, should be late enough that this place is open. Nearly. Give it a minute. Could sleep in that bed, but they should open right about now. There we go. Second try's the charm. All right, so let me heal everybody up. It's already partially healed because I had to sleep a bunch. And I'll be back, and we'll search for the Word of Power in this town. Alright, all healed up. Let's see what we can find here. So we're probably looking for a mage. It's funny I've spent so much time in Minok and not found the Word of Power yet. Must be something I don't know that I need to figure out here. So we've talked to the beggar here. His name was... Oh, hell if I can remember. Something. Delwyn. I can remember. Fenelon. Hey, are you? Is that a male or a female name? trying to figure out if she's the daughter of the whoever the heck it was I was supposed to ask about. Okay, no, not the person. Fair enough. We're also looking for a pirate named David. I don't think that's who is here. Wait, pirate named David. Probably somebody I could find at Buccaneer's Den. Yeah, okay, so we should... Wait, no. Scally was at the Buccaneer's Den, wasn't he? I'm sorry, I'm getting my notes all confused here. Let's just continue our search for the Word of Power. Oops. Fiona. Let's see if she leads us anywhere. We've already tried this. Haven't we? Yeah, I'm not sure what to do there. Is there anybody in the poorhouse we can talk to that we haven't yet? Who are you? Hey, we haven't talked to her yet. That was sick and injured. The plagues once thought gone have returned. It is carried by rats and other rodents. Yeah, that's a nasty one. Nasty, unclean creatures. Oops, naster. Mm-hmm. Beggar. Okay, so that's probably Delwyn. Don't know who that is. Let's poke around a little more here. I'm sure I can find what I'm looking for. Well, no, I'm not. I might need some information from elsewhere. I think I can probably find what I'm looking for. Who this? Fighter. That's Tactus. He's the one who gets us started on the... Hey! Let's talk to him with the black badge equipped. That seems like a good idea. Oh, he's beating me down there. What's the name of the thing that I'm a part of? Not the Resistance, the other one. Not Inquisition. Oh man, I'm drawing a complete blank on this. What is it called? Oppression. Nah, he doesn't care. Okay. Figured we might get something interesting for coming back to him with this on, but I guess not. Man, there's got to be something to find here. I'm going to find it. Let me poke around for a little bit off camera. I'll bring you back when I... Oh, hey, Delwyn. Oh, sure. Why not? This is the same... Shenstone, the armor, has been sneaking about town around noontime. And kind of virtue. He's not going to... Oh, damn it, I did this again. No, I'm not giving you any more money. Screw this. All right, I think he's run out of his usefulness. Yeah, again, I'm going to poke around here off camera, figure out what I'm doing, and I'll bring you back when I find something. Oh, here we go. I asked about sick the first time. This is a new conversation branch. This is Lady Sara. I asked her about injured instead. Many come to convalesce from injuries sustained in factional skirmishes. Factional skirmishes? They have lessened dramatically since martial law was imposed. That's Blackthorn. Blackthorn's done a good job given the circumstances. I not agree. No! Well, I do. Poor man, he's badly misunderstood. Where were we? Let's see. Marshall. Alright, if I say yes. If people would just let him, he'd straighten out a lot of this mess. Oh, man. This has got to be... I really feel like we're onto something here. Let's try this one more time. Injured, not insured. Many come to convalesce from injuries sustained in factional skirmishes. Less. factional. Lessened dramatically since martial law was imposed. Nope. Nothing to do here. Okay, so guess that's a dead end. I have a feeling she's important somehow, but don't know the right keyword yet. Okay, well, let me poke around a bit more. All right, well, it turns out that Rue is a female name. So this really feels like... So she's already given me the mantra, but I feel like she should be able to give me the word too, because isn't this who what's-his-name was talking about? Let's talk to her again. I already asked about word, right? Council. Oh, yeah, okay, so let's see. Another member of the council's daughter. No, you're not a member of the council. That's right, okay, the conversation's coming back to me a little better. I don't know. Apparently I don't have what I need right now to figure out... Oh, dang it. To figure out what this word of power is. So, let's just leave. Alright, let me see if there's anything else quick I can do today. Alright, well, here's one. Remember that Saduj character who we can find in the basement of Lord British's castle? He wanted to know if I was a member of the oppression. And since I kind of am now... Let's go talk to him and see if he has anything useful to say. So let's see. During the night, we found him up on the roof, trying to break into Lord British's private chambers. He sleeps here during the day, I think. Okay, well, no. He's there now. What time is it? 10:31 p.m. I'm just gonna sit here for a little while, see if he wakes up and I can talk to him. So I'll be right back in a bit. Aha, here we go. I was just about to give up, but he's here now. Okay. You're the one I'm looking for, right? Yep. So let's see, how do we do this? Gardener. Plants. Watering. Then he asks if I don't believe him. That matter, what are they doing here? Whatever. Likely story out there with the oppression. Yes. Prove it. What's the password? Impera. Greetings, friend. Knowest thou of my mission? no. Oh. Blackthorn himself sent me here to find an object hidden in Lord British's chambers. It is... I know not what it is, but it rests in a sandalwood box. If destroyed, there shall be no chance for that scourge British to return. Might I join thee that we might work together? No! Later, perhaps. Okay. Alright, so you're looking for the sandalwood box, which is in Lord British's chambers. Alright, let's see if we can cap this off with the quest that takes us in there to get the sandalwood box. I think it starts in Empath Abbey. Oops. So I'm going to go over there and see if I can get it started. So I'll see you when I'm in Empath Abbey. All right, we're here. We are looking for a person named Tim, and we must have missed him the first time that we were here, because I thought I was pretty thorough with this place. This is the place I came several times to sleep in a bed and could not quite... Hello? Ah, Toshi, you're a... potential party member, but I'm not looking for another bard. Okay, those are guards. Alright, we've done this enough times. Let me not waste your time wandering around here looking for what I'm seeking. Once I find Tim, I'll bring you back. There he is. That wasn't so bad. Bard for this castle. Okay, so I don't believe we've ever talked to this person before. Yes, I play and sing for the inhabitants of this castle. Empath Abbey. Wait. Start over. I know you lead me to... really? Dost thou enjoy fine harpsichord music? Here we go, yes. Since Lord British's disappearance, his court composer, Sir Kenneth, he's the one who taught us stones, is said to be traveling throughout Britannia. He trades music lessons for melodies. He is compiling a collection of Britannian folk music. Recently he gave a recital in Trinsic and then headed south. Yeah, that lighthouse down south from there. He often teaches a piece by Iolo and Gueno. That is not spelled right. 'Tis a favorite of Lord British. Some even say that to play the piece on the finest instrument may cause magical occurrences. Only on an instrument worthy of kings. Alright, so that's... I don't know. See, if I didn't already know this, I don't know if I'd be able to figure it out quite so easily. I don't know how I came by this knowledge. See, okay, let me give you a little backstory here. So I've said before that I've played this game when I was much younger. My brother, who is 7 years older than me, was playing it at the same time. And, you know, he knew... Hello. Oh, that's Iolo's hut. Right. Random dwelling in the woods. You know, he knew what he was doing a little better because, you know, he was older. He was actually using his brain when he was playing this. So, you know, he was progressing a lot faster than I was. And I kind of picked up things from him, notes that he made and things like that. Just learned little bits and pieces of the game from stuff that he had done. So a lot of my knowledge here is just secondhand from watching him play it. So one of the purposes of this LP is to do it firsthand and to see everything. That's why I'm trying to be so strict about making sure that I find the way the game tells me about something before I actually go and do it. So yeah, that's the story behind that. So anyway, don't know if I would have been able to figure this out if I didn't already know it from him. All right, I'm curious about something. Does this guy actually want to arrest me? You see, big... does that not know this is a restricted area? Okay, here we go. No. Shut up. They are not allowed up here. They are going to leave on their own, or must I take the off the battlements? Leave? How do I respond to that? Get off the roof now. All right, so he doesn't want me here. I couldn't remember if that guy just straight out arrested you when you were up there, or what. Okay, we can slip by him now. Good. Alright, so if we're in here, hey, we can get a second magic carpet. Cool, because yeah, that thing respawns. Oh, and man, I'm getting distracted by so many things here. Let's look in this telescope, because I've actually figured out how to read that now. Okay, so here's what it is. The manual lists, or the Book of Lore, that is, lists the eight virtues. I was reading this wrong. I was thinking this was basically like a first-person view looking in the telescope. That's not what it is. The telescope is here, and each planet up from there is a matter of distance away. So this is the closest planet. That's the second closest. This is the farthest one away. So that's how you read this. And yeah, the Book of Lore lists the eight virtues, and each town corresponds to one. In order from the telescope, each planet also corresponds to one. So this is honesty, compassion, valor, justice, sacrifice, honor, spirituality, and humility. So knowing the order of those and the order of the planets... planets? Yeah, planets. Not the moons. Away from... the planet we're on, I guess Britannia, we can determine which one of these is which. So let's see, honesty, compassion. So the town of Compassion currently has a Shadow Lord visiting it. Compassion is Britain. So yeah, we know that. Okay, so then valor, justice, sacrifice, honor. The town of Honor is Trinsic, so that one has a Shadow Lord too. Spirituality, humility. That's New Magincia. Hey, that's a place we need to go. Because we just poked our head in there and then left right away. Anyway, so that's how you read this telescope. I figured it out. But yeah, while we're in here, what we want to do is play stones. Let's see, is it... Oh, I missed. Try again. we go. Okay, so you play that here. It opens up this passage, which has a sandalwood box in it. So that's how you get the sandalwood box. You know what? I don't remember what that's for, but apparently it's important. How? And if we observe the geometry here, we can see that there's something through the fireplace. Let's just do that. Black potion and Antim. Very nice. Okay. So now I believe we've gotten all the things that we need to get in here. It's nothing under his bed, right? No. All right, let's see if we can escape without getting arrested. I have two magic carpets now, just in case that ever comes in handy. And Mr. Saduj was also looking for the sandalwood box, so we do not want to let him get his hands on it. I believe if you let him join you, he'll steal it from you. So let's not do that. But anyway, there's no reason I'd ever let him join me anyway, because he'll just kill me if I give him the chance. All right, so that's going to do it for today. Next time, yeah, between this time and the next, I'm going to do some dungeoning. Well, see, I don't want to do too much of that off camera. Okay, I'll do it off camera, but I'll record in case anything interesting happens, because I need to get my levels up, and I need to get some loot, some gold. Yeah, so I'm going to be doing that for a little while. But yeah, we'll pick it up next time. See you guys then.